Hi, how's it going, my fellow netdeckers? So today we'll be playing a Talia Katarina deck. Talia is probably one of the most interesting champions in this new set. I'll put this at the same level as Lissandra. They both have interesting card effect. And personally, I would prefer Talia more because Talia's level of ability allows her to deal 6 direct damage at your opponent's nexus. So if you are a burn lover, you like to deal direct damage to your opponent's nexus, Talia is actually quite an interesting champion to play. Basically, how we're going to play Talia in this deck is we're going to make use of Talia's ability to summon an exact copy of an allied landmark. We're going to use it on our Sandswept Tome, so we have 2 tomes on the battlefield. And whenever we attack, we are able to create 2 Sandstone Charger, which is very strong here. Sandstone Charger is basically 2 for 5/2. Being able to hit for 5 is a lot of damage. We're going to use that alongside with Katarina as well. So the goal here is to try and level up Katarina in the early game. And when she's leveled up, we are able to use her to rally. So we can summon several ways of Sandstone Charger and also attack with Talia multiple times to deal high amounts of direct damage. This deck is like your typical combo deck. You are trying to build towards this combo that I just explained. Aside from that, we have other cards to support our game plan. We have Golden Ambassador to help us draw a champion and gives our champion +2/+2. Being able to grant +2/+2 to Katarina is actually quite advantageous here as we get her out of the range of cards like Get Excited and Mystic Shot. And besides that, we also have our Shurima staples. We have Ancient Preparation and Aspiring Colomancer to help us predict and allow us to draw the key cards that we need to build our insane combo here. Lastly, we have Ruinous Path, which is a very versatile card. It allows us to draw 1, which is very useful when couple it with our prediction card because we can predict the card that we want and we can draw it immediately, and we are also able to drain 2 from the enemy nexus. This is very crucial in certain situations where we are short of like 2 damage to deal lethal to the opponent. Overall, this is a very enjoyable deck to play. Once you are able to set up this combo, you are able to attack your opponent with a relentless amount of Sandstone Charges. This is definitely an upgrade from your Azure Sand Soldier deck. If you enjoy those decks, and sometimes if you question yourself, you know, why these Sand Soldiers are too weak, you might be interested in this deck because you are attacking with way stronger Sand Soldiers. You are attacking with waves upon waves of Sandstone Charger with the help of our Katarina and our Talia. So if you are interested in this deck, you can find the deck code in the description below, and I hope you guys enjoy the gameplay.
I can't figure out what deck this is. I can't. I can't really recognize it though. Yeah, as much as Spirit Fire is great, 7 cost is like way too high. Two Spirit Fire. Okay, so it's a concurrent timeline stack. So we just wait for turn 9 to die. That's unfortunate, isn't it? Jeez. Go for Ancient Prediction Preparation here. Oh, this is what I want. Turn 5 Sandstone into our Talia. Yeah, Sandswept Tome. Then our Sandswept Tome can be copied by Talia's ability. And we have our Katarina here. If she doesn't die to Mystic Shot, we can attack with twice the Sandswept Stone Tome. Jeez. He can't even let me do that. But it's fine, it's fine. I think down the line we can probably draw another one. Because we have another card that allow us to draw. Hey, we should have used the Blade's Edge to deal damage to his nexus. Yep, so this is the card that I was referring to. We can draw another Katarina, so maybe we can drop this on turn 7 or something before we die to Dredros. Everyone's a garden. Okay, let's block here. Nice. I guess you can predict this. Then we can... Oh, nice. Katarina, we do not even need our Golden Ambassador now. Maybe we shouldn't have choose Golden Ambassador. No, maybe we shouldn't have went to Katarina since we're going to draw a... But it's not guaranteed, right? It's a bit sad that he always have to change his creatures. I told you I would be here. So he could have gained like 4 health, but unfortunately that's the case. Nice! So cool. Please let me attack, please don't quit. Please don't surrender. You just need to last until turn 9, god damn it. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, I think we should attack with everything. I mean, if he trades, then he trades, so be it. Let's put it here. So imagine if we had Katarina here, we could have done twice, you know. He has to block here, otherwise I'm gonna do like 6 damage in total. 21 damage, Jesus. Jeez. Oh. Actually, I was hoping for a better sound effect. It's like stones, like boulders, instead of like just porcelains, like hitting against the ground. But it's still not bad. It's still quite a cool like ability and all. Okay, that's fine.
We live in hallowed times.
Not exactly what I was hoping for. Okay, so we are 2 mana away from Dredros, so that's a good thing. That's perfect. Okay, and this, with the amount of mana we have, we can hit twice, which is awesome. He's dead. Let's open attack here and we win. Oh, finally I can pull off this combo. Awesome. Wow, the onslaught can't be stopped. It's always so cool to get this combo running, but it's quite hard. Yeah, it's not exactly a top tier deck, but it's quite a cool deck.
Violence solves everything.
Yeah, violence solves everything. Wow, an expert. What, TF Feast player. So the question here is whether Spirit Fire will kill Fizz or not, because this doesn't go on the stack, or it resolves immediately. I think we just keep it to deal with all the small creatures that is going to come out anyway, so that's fine. But we need to be... Like we just need to ensure that we have like enough mana banked for Spirit Fire, because I don't think we're gonna last till turn 7. I think turn 2 we're gonna skip, then we're gonna drop Katarina with her Blades Edge so we can shoot one of them down. Yeah, we can drop one Ancient Preparations here to kind of help us get some better cards next turn, like in the upcoming turns as well. So he has nothing, which is odd. We can get another Ancient Preparations to push for Talia's level up condition here. Seems like he's just passing the turn back to me to check what I'm playing. That's fine. Ooh.
Tide's coming in.
Yeah, this is the part where we need to kind of save up mana, isn't it? Let's go with our Katarina.
Let the bloodshed begin.
I think we have to be cautious of suit up as well.
That's fine. No point shooting Fizz. He's gonna deny it anyway. You can kind of expect that, isn't it? It's a TF Fizz deck. You're gonna take another 2 here, but that's fine. Can go for Perseverium here. Ooh. He's not getting the cards he needs, that's why he's casting that. So let's hope that we try and set out a combo faster than his. Sure. Let's keep our 2 mana here. So at least next turn, if anything goes crazy, you can just Spirit Fire. This is actually not too bad. Would you look at this place? Okay, I think now is a good time to drop Ancient Preparation to try and get some good cards here, because we have been drawing quite bad cards, like very small creatures that I don't think we can deal with. It's not sufficient to win the game for us. And we are just on the defensive here. He's gonna be cautious with this as well. He can't drop Twisted Fate here. Okay. Go with this. Okay, our Talia level up really? Yep, she's leveled up already. So that's great. Don't really care here, let's attack. We'll just do this instead. Because, we want to get out of the range of minimally a Mystic Shot. So if you were to cast Shape Stones, right? This will get out of the range of Mystic Shot. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, suit up. We need to get our Talia. That is 5 damage. Jeez. Let's go with Ruinous Path here. And draw some cards. Hopefully it's useful for us. If need be, you can use Spirit Fire to kind of reduce their attack. I think once we drop him on Vulnerable, that should be fine. We have 8 here, so we can just probably drop Spirit Fire. Nice! Yeah. I think the only problem with Fizz decks is that they can deny everything, but they can't really deal with combat tricks, you know. Take 5, 5 is fine. Can't do much anyway. How much is that for? Jeez. So it seems like it's not going to drop that. Guess that's fine. Yeah, this is an instant hit, you know. He can't avoid it at all. And we'll just attack into him with our Bakai Sand Spinner because since this gets out of the range of Mystic Shot and get excited, isn't it? Concerning? Slightly concerning? Let's just try and do this then. Should I even do this? No. I should just use this instead. This is a guaranteed. He really depends on his fees a lot.
But you see, the problem here is that he can draw another feast very soon. And sadly, we are not drawing any of our champions here.
Fall to pieces.
Yeah. And right now, we do not have any mana left. So if he gets excited here, he just dies. Jeez. Oh no. Okay, I have a feeling that he has a feast somewhere in his deck. He's gonna draw it soon. Sure. Dang. He just needs to draw more fees, and I think he should be able to win the game, right? And he gets to drop the card first. I can't like cast my rock hopper here and do anything here. No, I'm not gonna let him. I'm not gonna let it like wait out, you know. So, normally in this kind of situation, if he passes, I'm just gonna pass. I'm just gonna like take the turn. Nice. It's time. Oh shit, we don't have enough mana, jeez.
Deal me in.
What's that?
All that glitters.
Oh, proud city.
He just discarded his mystic shot, right? The chances is quite low for him to kill this. Ah shit. Not gonna happen. Not gonna happen. Haha! Let's kill him here. We do not even have Leto. Jeez, this is a bad hand. This is like, we are not drawing very well. Like, generally, we should be able to draw our combo. We have Sand Sweat Tomes. Then we can duplicate it with Talia, and we have Katarina to like hit twice. But this is unfortunate. I think we should be able to win next turn. With that, we can. But we are keep on just eating our own mana. That's a problem. We can't possibly cast this here. That's why.
Suns beneath me and winds behind me.
Yeah, we might just go for Katarina here. Is he gonna level up? Nope. He's not.
You got caught. Let the bloodshed begin.
I mean, he can attack for 5. That's fine. What is that? Deal 1. Do I want this to happen? And that's fine.
Oh dear.
Can't really do much anyway, right? I guess Twisted Fate gets a clean hit here.
Smiling.
I think I want to save my mana here. So we have 9 here, finally. Jeez.
Together, we are stronger than stone.
At least I know that the good thing here is that he doesn't have any stuns or anything, so I can just attack here. But you see, the problem here is that we do not have even
any, we don't even have any landmarks at all. It's like, jeez. I think we're just gonna go with landmarks here. So we can try and gun him down with this. So at least we deal 2 damage. We can do this 2 more times. So with a landmark here, we can at least do 3 times. No!
Now this game's heating up.
Ooh. Twisted Fate. Ah. He's aiming for lethal, isn't he? Serpentine. This is a bit sad though, I can't do the Sand Swept Tome combo here. Do we get lethal? No. If we have Overwhelm, we have been great, right? That would have been perfect. But we still get lethal here. We still get lethal. Jeez, we won! I can't believe this game took so long. I can't imagine putting you guys through this. It was such a... I think this deck, right, is quite fun to play. But it's just... getting all the cards in place is the difficult part. And this is just like a bit draggy, but if your cards are in place, right, you are able to do quite well. You can do the Sand Swept Tome combo. So you can like duplicate 2 Sand Swept Tome. Then you use your Katarina to hit twice. Yeah, let's just go in Ruinous Path here. You win the game already anyway. He can't even heal himself up. I think I'll just create another video to showcase, hopefully try and get the combo out. I think this is just good enough for a second video. You know?